In Egypt, there are many different needs, societal needs, both in terms of healthcare delivery, but also in terms of economic factors. You know, for example, that the pharmaceutical industry is very, very important in Egypt. So when we're designing our education program, we have to take, first of all, the needs and priorities of the country into consideration. The next point that we look at is, what services do we need our pharmacists and other members of the pharmacy workforce, whether they're pharmaceutical scientists, or I know you don't formally have technicians in your factory, but support personnel that are supporting pharmacists, what services do we need them to provide? And once we know what services we're going to provide in order to meet the needs, we have to identify what competencies, knowledge, skills, attitudes, and values that the members of the pharmacy workforce must have to enable them to provide those services. Once we know what competencies they need, we can design our educational program. And I think one of the questions that came up yesterday, and it seemed a lot of the members in the audience were a little bit supportive of the idea of reducing the amount of pharmacognosy in the curriculum. Did I get that right? I think quite a few people felt there was maybe too much pharmacognosy in the curriculum. But essentially, we have to know, when we build our curriculum, everything in that curriculum must help to achieve the competencies that we need in order that our pharmacists can provide services and can meet needs. So if you think about the needs that you have in Egypt, they're going to be probably a little bit different to the needs of society in the United States. There will be many common needs. Absolutely, there will be many common needs. But there will be differences as well, which will determine what services we need our pharmacists to provide, what competencies, and what education. So, for example, if natural products and herbal products are very, very important for the population in Egypt, maybe many, many people use herbal products, there's definitely a need to have in your curriculum some knowledge and some exposure. Of course, the difficult question is how much is right? And I think everywhere where pharmacy education is delivered, we ask that question. What is the right balance between basic sciences, whether it's pharmacognosy, pharmaceutics, medicinal chemistry, or some of the more clinical and applied sciences like pharmacotherapy, practice experiences? What's the appropriate balance? And I'm not sure that anyone yet believes they have the perfect balance in education. And of course, one of the issues as well is that education is constantly changing. And so you have to be in a very dynamic situation, knowing what is right. So maybe some of the ways in which we designed our educational programs in the past are changing to keep up with the quickly evolving profession. That was one of the slides that I wanted to show you. The second slide that I wanted to show you was, I think, a very, very important fact to think about as we are developing a vision. Yesterday we spoke about a vision for practice and a vision for education. In this very simple diagram, and I know it's perhaps an oversimplification, but it's a very simple diagram talking about three major sectors within a profession. So at the top you have regulation or policy. This is usually controlled or driven by the government. Sometimes there's different models, but usually this is controlled by the government. And then we have the two other main sectors that we're going to be talking about, that we are talking about at this conference: practice and education. And that diagram there is intended to represent the dynamic relationship that should exist between these three sectors. And in the United States or in Egypt or any country around the world, it's vitally important that those sectors are working together to advance the profession. Yesterday, Dr. Ali had a diagram about a two-directional, bi-directional relationship. I'm not sure if you remember that from his slide. Very similar depiction here. It's this bi-directional push and pull which should exist between these sense, I believe, within the profession. Very, very important that there's a common vision and all sectors are working together. Unfortunately, my experience has been that it's not always the case that the sectors are working together in a very coordinated and collaborative way to achieve the advance of the profession and achieving the vision, the vision. In fact, in many countries, there doesn't even exist a national vision for what pharmacy practice and pharmacy education should be. Our experience in the United States, unfortunately, is that our sectors within the profession do actually work together quite well most of the time. I don't think it's perfect, but we do work together quite well most of the time. And there is a common vision in the United States for what pharmacy practice should be, what it should achieve, and how education also should support the achievement of that vision. Later on, I'm going to talk about the role of accreditation. This is the logo for my organization, the accrediting body. And I feel that we sit right in the middle of that relationship. And it's also important that as we, my organization, develops standards for pharmacy education, both degree programs as well as continuing education, it's also vitally important that we are working with different sectors of the profession, all the stakeholders who have an interest in the quality of education to ensure that we are advancing. So what are we going to try and do today? Well, I have invited several of the major pharmacy organizations in the United States, and I want to thank them all very, very much for their support, for being here. And I would ask you to also please join me in thanking them all for coming today. What we would like to do, five of us, myself and four other speakers, is share our experience in the United States with how we believe our organizations or our sector of practice or education has helped to drive and advance clinical pharmacy and clinical education in the United States. So each of us are going to be sharing our story today. Again, please, what I would encourage you to do is to think about some lessons learned. Each of the speakers are going to talk about some lessons learned and some core principles in terms of advancing pharmacy practice and education. But what you are going to be doing after lunch today is